It was the development we were dreading and feared was coming. Confirmation tonight, two miners involved in an accident at a site in outback Queensland have died. Straight to Sally Guyte, who's at the Dugald River Mine. Sally, what has the mining company had to say tonight?
Yeah, good evening, Ange. The mining companies have confirmed the deaths of Trevor Davis and Dylan Langridge. They were both in their 30s, both contractors who worked here for a few years at the Dugald River Zinc Mine here in northwest Queensland, and both who were killed when their ute fell into a void, seeing them trapped 125 metres beneath the surface. And immediately a frantic, delicate, desperate rescue operation ensued. Regular workers from the site, as well as their mates, colleagues and specialist mine rescue operators, immediately getting into that effort to rescue the two men. They were using drone technology, void mapping technology, but sadly the two men, when they were found, were discovered with fatal injuries. Mining company Perenti has said this outcome is simply unacceptable, saying that their primary focus is now supporting the loved ones, family and colleagues of the two men. The Australian Workers Union put it best when they said that every mining family has this thought in the back of their mind that something like this could happen, and when it does happen, it is simply terrifying. I understand the mining regulator has already begun a thorough investigation into the circumstances behind this incident, and we'll find out what additional measures need to be put in place to prevent anything like this from happening again. Ange?
Yeah, it's certainly tragic. Okay, thanks so much, Sally Guy. I want to bring in mining safety expert Professor David Cliff from the University of Queensland. Good evening to you. This is obviously a devastating outcome. The company says the drill rig and ute fell 15 metres into a backfilled stope. What does that actually mean?
Okay, the stope is an underground cavity or tunnel that's drilled horizontally into an ore body. From there they can drill up or down and put explosives in to bring the ore down into that area. Then they move further down into the mine and repeat the process. That creates a cavity between these horizontal roadways, which they can then backfill with waste rock or material they don't want to mine out of the pit. Normally that waste material can be solidified or consolidated. It appears in this instance that they've been on top of this pile of waste material and it's given way.
So obviously the investigation is very much in its infancy. Can you understand from your experience, years of experience, how this could have happened?
This is a very rare event. I'm not aware of similar backfill failure in Australia. Historically, people who have fallen down holes underground, they have been holes that have been constructed for a specific purpose for transporting ore down the mine, and they've either gone too far and gone over the edge into an existing hole rather than a hole being created.
When was the last time we had a mining disaster as significant as this here in Australia?
I think it was in Tasmania back in 2014, where two men fell down a shaft. And in the last 12 months, there have been five single fatalities in Australian mining. The fact that we continue to have fatalities is unacceptable.
What do we know about the company involved? Has their safety been called into question before?
MMG are the owners or operators of the mine. They then have subcontracted to Perenti, who run a group of companies, one of which is called Buminco, which is an experienced underground mining contracting company. They haven't had a fatality for a number of years, and their overall safety performance, as it's officially reported, seems quite reasonable.
In general, what do you think of the safety standards across Australian mines?
In general, the mining industry is a very safe industry. It's highly mechanised, very high technology, lots of sophisticated systems. Unfortunately, sometimes those systems fail or are not applied diligently or vigilantly, and we have accidents. We are in the process of, I think in the last 3 years, we've had two parliamentary inquiries into mine safety, largely driven out of the coal sector. But this will be another impetus to step deeply into the mining sector, because this is now the metalliferous sector, which up until to date has been suffering less fatalities than the coal and less serious injuries than coal.
Well, thanks so much for your expertise and time tonight, Professor David Cliff.